All my life, Bank Street neighbors have found their way into my heart and my writing. At 11 Bank, artist Yeffie Kimball and physicist Harvey Slayton were spied on by a famous Broadway actress while sharing their place with a very lively ghost. At One Bank, Stella Crater was at the center of one of the biggest sex scandals in U.S. history. Then there was the time my neighbors, John Lennon and Yoko Ono, came by and I accidentally soaked them with water from the window. It was here at 105 Bank that the FBI slipped deportation papers under their door. My beloved babysitter, Marion Tanner, the real Auntie Mame, here at 72 Bank, taught me to open my heart to those in need. My friend Billy Joyce threw fabulous dinner parties right here on the sidewalk at 113 Bank.
With china, crystal, cloth napkins and all.
Poet Langston Hughes brought the Harlem Renaissance to 23 Bank. Hollywood actor Theodore Bickel lived here, while Rex Harrison, his co-star in My Fair Lady, was carrying on with a famous actress right across the street.
How delicious it might have been if Theodore Bickel had seen Rex Harrison tiptoeing down the steps of that actress's apartment.
Politician Bella Abzug fought for women's rights and gay rights, and fought with my father a lot, too. Lifelong friends and famous actors, the Guilfords and the Bravermans, unofficially adopted me and I them. They all lived here at Bank in Abingdon Square. And in 1979, right here on the 63 Bank Street stoop, I was ambushed by reporters.
Did you know that Vicious was staying here?
Yeah, I did.
And found out on camera that my neighbor, Sid Vicious of the Sex Pistols, had just overdosed on heroin across the hall. In good times and bad, Bank Street has provided me with stories, lessons, and adventures. It feels amazing to still live at 63 and share these stories with the world in my book, Growing Up Bank Street.